I know you can probably sense I'm a bit of a badass. Not, I don't mean because of that story, but I mean, you can tell I have a tattoo. I know you can. I have, not everyone gets one, you know. There's badasses and the rest of you. But I have a tattoo. And I'm only gonna have one. And I think the whole tattoo thing is actually a lot like kids. Like, first of all, some people want one. Some people want none. Some people want a bunch, like, and it's all over their arms and it just looks like a lot of work, you know? But you go to a place, you lay down, there's a lot of pain, and you're like, God, I hope I love it. It is permanent. So I'm having a tattoo instead of a child. And so for me, I'm one of the one-and-doneer types. So you know that my tattoo has to be very meaningful, right? If you've ever thought about getting a tattoo, you think about it for a while, and you're like, I just don't want to get something dumb on me. I have to have something that means something. And I've been waiting my whole life to find something succinct that means something that I can put on my body permanently. And I thought of something a couple years ago, and I was like, don't do it right away. Give it another year, and if you're still thinking about it, then do it. So that's what I did. And I was inspired by my friend who got a tattoo of her grandfather's name on her wrist and his birthday, because he has an amazing story. So my friend's grandfather survived the Holocaust because he was a Nazi. But no, that's okay. That's just a fun joke. That is not... I didn't set you guys up. There really is a story about my friend. But I just had to throw in because he was... It's not. My friend's grandfather really did survive the Holocaust. And my friend, just like her father and her father's father, and like many of us in this country, suffers from depression and anxiety. And the story he would tell was the survival story of his mind, of when he was in the camps, he would say a prayer of gratitude to God and say, if this has to end this way, fine. But thank you for making me me and not one of the evil people. Thank you for putting love in my heart. And that is mind-blowing. Of course, you put that guy's name on your wrist. It's the most beautiful story I've ever heard. And I don't have anyone in my family like that. I come from a family of Catholic people from Boston, and we don't talk to God like that. We don't like God. We are mad at God, and we assume he's mad at us. Jennifer, why would you have gratitude for a bad thing that happened? That means God's mad at you. He's punishing you. Jennifer, why would you have gratitude for God being so mean to you? Maybe he'll think you like it there, and he'll keep you in there. Bothering God with all this gratitude unless something good happens. And nothing bad's ever happened in our family, but it could, and we're gonna complain about it in advance, and we're gonna stay vigilant. So no tattoos of anything our family said, please. So I had to go elsewhere. So I'll show you my tattoo, and then I'll explain. Thank you.
It's on my ankle.
It's on my ankle. It says JKL, which stands for JK Livin, which stands for Just Keep Livin, which is Matthew McConaughey's catchphrase. Thank you. This tattoo could not be less ironic at all. I mean it with all my heart. Just Keep Livin inspires me. And I'm not suicidal. I'm a soul trapped in a body. I didn't ask to be born, and I'm afraid to die, and that's the shit I live in every day. And so... I love what you get excited about. Yeah, that's right! We're trapped! Now, before you judge, if you think I'm just some shallow Hollywood person, no. There's a story behind Just Keep Living. Just like my friend had a story behind her tattoo of her grandfather. So I'm at the nail salon and I'm having a bad day. But I don't know why I'm having a bad day. I just don't feel good. Physically, I feel fine. Mentally, not into it. So I'm scrolling through People magazine and I see an article about Matthew McConaughey. Well, he had a tough day once too. Not sure why you're laughing. This is very serious. He was filming Dazed and Confused, and he knew he was going to be a big star. But his father was dying, so he was like, something good and something bad is happening at the same time. Well, I guess I better just keep living. And then that became his catchphrase. And I see you're not as moved to silence by it as you were that Holocaust story. And that's fine. Different things for different people. The thing about this tattoo is it's in an inconvenient place. If my friend is having a bad day, she can remind herself, hey, it's not as bad as my grandfather had it, by going like this. I have to be like, I will board this plane in a minute. I'm having a bad day and I need a reminder of, go ahead. People say things to me about tattoos like, you're gonna regret it when you're older. It looks dumb. I'm like, it looks dumb now. I'm all set. Thank you.